Get ready to match the stars. Richard Long, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Flew, Richard Dawson, and Kay Stevens as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rutter.
Jenny Olsen, listen, you're a grand bunch.
Hey, right on.
Heel.
Heel.
Cease.
I'm
cease.
Sorry.
Do not holler at my friends
they're
out my there.
They're my sort of people.
Yeah,
listen,
they're
I
nice.
Love your mother's strudel.
What's
your
that?
Your mother made the best
strudel. Oh, my mother's visiting
wait
us.
Wait one minute. I have an appointment to register.
What's wrong?
I took two pieces of strudel that your mother made,
yeah.
And I placed them in my dressing room.
And they're gone.
And I'm not accusing anybody.
But.
I'm sitting on one of them.
Kate, what's her name? Stole my strudel.
You ate her strudel.
I ate her strudel.
Isn't that awful? She ate her strudel.
I ate it, and I'm glad.
Sorry,
I would like another piece.
Where is your mom? Is she here?
My mom is right here. Where is
she? Get her on camera.
Mama,
we can
mama.
Let her earn a couple of dollars.
Yay, Jean's mama.
Terrific. You see where she's sitting? There she is.
Oh, a lot of class. Thank you. Yes.
All right. I see they gave you the best seat in the house, Mom. Now, we have with us here Kathy Graff, who's won $6,800, and she's happy about that. She's being challenged by Margot Chase there, and we're in the middle of round one, right? Okay, ladies. We'll have a go at it right after we have a go at this message for you. Here we go. Okay. Now push this button, ladies, and reveal our first round question, which we have for Kathy. Margot did not score in her half of the first round.
I was trying to score when you
started. That's all right. Let's see how Kathy does with her first round question.
Okay.
Nanook's mother said.
Nanook?
Nanook. You know who Nanook is?
Of the North?
Yes,
Nanook,
but I'd rather not say.
Nanook's mother said, I knew that Nanook had been necking with his new girlfriend because when he came back to the igloo, his nose was blank. Didn't hear it all. Oh, yes. Here we go again. Nanook's mother said, I knew that Nanook had been necking with his new girlfriend because when he came back to the igloo, his nose was blank.
I got it.
You got the idea.
Look, we're finished here.
I know.
That's right. You neck a lot, do you? You knew it. I see. I don't know if it would work with three of us or not.
Let's try it.
Okay. All right, you're out of it.
Me and that girl over there.
Okay.
And Johnny.
I want Johnny.
All right. Put it in the slot there. Charles. Okay. Charles, we're going to have to start without you. Okay. Now, Kathy. Nanook's mother said, I knew that Nanook had been necking with his new girlfriend because when he came back to the igloo, his nose was...
Red.
Red. A perfectly reasonable answer she has given.
Far too reasonable for me.
Really?
Covered with whale oil.
Covered with whale oil.
What was he doing?
His new girlfriend was a whale.
More than you do.
His new girlfriend is a whale, according to Richard Long.
That was just what I was going to ask him.
Yes. What do you say?
Well,
here?
I very often, as you know, draw on my own personal experiences for these answers.
Yes, of course.
And his nose was hot.
Hot. Aha. Okay, the igloo began
that.
To melt. Charles?
Well, they kiss with their noses, right?
Right.
So I wrote bruise, and he also had a hickey sickle.
A hickey sickle. Well,
that was rude.
Yes, it was. Red is the answer Kathy is looking for.
What is
when he came back
sickle?
To the igloo, his nose was red, is what she said.
I think that's probably the most logical thing I could think of. So I said red.
Red it is. There's a match for you. All right. Richard II, the lion-hearted, what do you say?
Oh, I dated Nanook.
You dated Nanook?
You would.
Yeah. Hmm. Well, somebody's got a
dollar. Aren't they adorable?
Yeah.
Not necessarily.
Red. Is your nose red now?
My true love's nose.
There it is. Okay, that's good for you. I guess a nose will get red when you neck that way, right?
Sure.
Chap blue. Yeah, they don't call it necking.
Oh, well, you have to neck with me, too.
No, all right. They don't call it necking, they call it nosing.
Oh, you do great nose.
Come great on, show nose. Us your card and stop
this foolishness. Oh, I thought running, but I said red.
Red, okay. So it's three for you. Now we go to round two, Margot. There we go. Ask you to make a selection.
Bait, please.
All right, now you must match three to stay in the game. And here we go. Norma said, Jimmy's hair is so greasy, he polishes his blank with his head. Jimmy's hair is so greasy, he polishes his blank with his head.
Oh, I have it. I
know you got it.
Oh, Brett, over Brett.
Brett got one.
Watch it, I'll punch in the mouth.
Oh.
So ladylike, isn't
it? Oh, yes. Class.
What finishing school did you go to, Brett?
Belzer's.
Okay.
What was that? Saint
nothing. How come you put your glasses on?
To see.
Oh.
The better to see you with, my dear.
You like this wig she's wearing?
Yeah.
Nice, isn't it? I like it.
She bought it from Mike Mazurki.
All right, everybody's finished over there, so Margot Chase, we come to you. Norma said, Jimmy's hair is so greasy, he polishes his blank with his head.
His shoes?
His shoes? Do that. That's hard to do, isn't it?
Well, you have to be younger and limberer.
Lumber and younger. What do you say there?
Well, I was just going to say, I don't know how that's possible, but I said shoes.
Shoes. Okay, Margo, you got one. Shoes the answer she's looking for, Brett.
I thought I was really swinging this time. I said furniture.
Furniture was not a bad answer.
And of course, I'm a domestic.
Well, that's, and you do windows.
Mine is dirty, so I said car.
Car. Shoes is what she's looking for. What do you got there? You offering shoes?
No, I'm offering a car.
A car?
Yes.
Got to match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game, Margot. Let's see if it happens. All right, sir. It's up to you.
You.
Well, don't get nasty. I said auto, darling.
Auto, sir. Kathy wins the game. Another $100 for you.
No car.
Well, Margot. Sorry to see you go. You're a lovely lady. We wish you the very best of luck. We've got a gift for you backstage,
thank
together with our thanks for being with us. A match game.
I think it's a great show.
Thank you. Goodbye, Margot. All right. You're going to have a chance to catch another brass ring or $5,700 or whatever it is here. But first, we've got to do a little business here and get some money for you. Here we go. Here we go with Kathy Graff one more time here. You ready?
Oh, yes.
Okay, Kathy. I'll see how you do now with the Big Money Supermatch. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blow your blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. And if you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match the third, you get $100. Whom do you choose for some help here?
Joanne.
This is tacky. But blow your nose.
It's tacky. All right. One more.
Okay. Blow your horn.
Blow your horn. Two. One more.
Richard.
What do you say, Richard?
Ah. I'm so glad you asked me, darling. I shall think of a good one for you. Blow your...
whistle.
Just a second. Blow your whistle.
Very good.
Did you hear that, Spur?
I thought that
that's
was excellent.
Terrific that you thought of that so spontaneously.
By yourself.
Well, it's years of training, isn't
okay.
it?
Okay.
Blow your mind.
So you got blow your nose, blow your whistle, blow your horn. You want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
I'll go with blow your nose.
Really?
Blow your nose?
Now, wait a minute.
That was
you want the tacky
good
answer, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, blow your nose. That's her choice there. All right, we'll find out what's up there right now by revealing first the $100 response. Blow your mind.
That
no
was
one
Brett.
Said that, huh?
Blow
Brett.
Your mind.
Yeah. Nah, nah, that's enough. Cut. All right, we're looking for blow your nose. Here is the $250 response. Blow your nose it is. Congratulations, you got the $250.
Blow your nose if you think he's guilty.
He'll get you out.
Listen, what about blow your top?
Blow your whistle.
Blow your top.
Blow your bottom.
I say it's blow your top. Blow your top. I don't care what you
top. Blow your bottom.
Top. Cut.
Horn. Horn. I'm getting a headache.
See, open it. Let's see what it is.
Horn. You're fired.
Ask him if he has a whistle in there.
Okay, so you've got the $250. Now you play for $2,500 by matching one celebrity head-to-head. Exactly. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Richard, get ready to write.
You see, it paid off.
Yes, sir. You face me. Here we go. The $2,500 question, Richard. Blank out. Blank out. Or blank out.
Sit down, Charles.
He is finished. Now we need an answer from you, Kathy, which you think will match his. What do you say? Blank out.
Black?
Blackout. I like that answer. All right, Richard, $2,500. She says blackout will match you. What do you say?
Will if I have a blackout. I said strikeout, Donald.
Strikeout. She had blackout over there. All right. They're both good answers. Strikeout is not bad. Blackout is very good. They're all good. All right. Now, Kathy, you're up to $7,150. Here comes your new opponent, Dick Harper. Hello, Dick Harper. What do you say? Dick, you know Kathy Graff? How are you, Dick Harper? You want to tell us a little bit about yourself, please?
Yes, I'm a motorcycle policeman for the city of Los Angeles. I have a lovely wife, Pat, lovely daughter, Nikki, and I play basketball for the Los Angeles Police Department basketball team.
How tall are you?
6'4", if I stand up straight.
We all have the same problem there. What's that say on your tie, may I?
It was a tie my wife gave me.
It's a very pretty tie.
Thank you.
It's got a little legend on it. It's a travel tie, isn't it? All right, Dick, if you're ready, I'll push his button and ask you to make a selection here. A or B?
Try A.
A. All right. This is what we've got for you and for the law there. Pete said, I'm opening a chain of fast food restaurants in Alaska. Instead of Chicken Delight, I'm calling them Blank Delight. You don't understand now, listen. It's very simple.
Oh, I got it.
Pete said, I'm opening a chain of fast food restaurants in Alaska. You know what fast food is. It's all prepackaged and prepared and all that. And instead of Chicken Delight, I'm calling them Blank Delight. Now, just see what's going on here.
It's wicked, whatever it is.
All right.
I'm mad at the Los Angeles Police Department.
Charles...
It can't win. Isn't that awful?
Anything you say.
They were cranky with me when I called them.
Oh, really? What'd you call them about? Don't answer. Okay. Now, Dick, Pete said I'm opening a chain of fast food restaurants in Alaska. Instead of Chicken Delight, I'm calling them Blank Delight.
How about Bear Delights?
Bear Delight. Polar Bear, right?
Polar Bear.
Bear Delight. Okay. What do you say? He said Bear Delight.
No, I hate to disagree with the law, but I said Blubber Delight.
Blubber Delight. Good. Blubber Delight. What do you say, Brett?
There was no revenge in this answer. It was nothing personal. I said Penguin Delight.
Penguin Delight. All right, Charles.
I'll take two Penguin Delights.
Two Penguin Delights to go.
No.
Hold the mustard. How about you, little girl?
Well, it's frozen tundra land up there.
That's right, it's frozen tundra.
So I said frozen delight.
You said frozen delight.
Thank you.
Why didn't you say tundra delight?
What's on the menu there, Richard?
Oh, something all police officers enjoy. In Alaska, unfortunately. You're from L.A.? Walrus delight.
Walrus delight.
We could have them, of course, delivered, or we do stay open until 3 in the morning.
Okay.
And sit we on still our hundreds.
We still haven't come to Bear Delight, which is his answer,
Yes,
okay?
Sir, that's my blubber nose.
Blubber Delight. Is it? I'm trying.
All right, nothing for you there in your first round question. We'll see how Kathy does with hers in a moment or so, but right now, friends, we want you to pay attention to this. Now we've got a first round question for Kathy. Ready? This is it, Kathy. Everybody plays. Hey, I got a little limerick for you.
A limerick.
Oh, good.
A limerick.
Well, read the question first.
A young man now, here's a limerick. Cod.
There was a young heiress named Fitches.
Fitches?
Who had simply incredible twitches.
Twitches.
She asked Dr. Blade to come to her aid, so he quickly removed her...
I love this
now,
show.
There are a number of good choices here. And a number of bad ones.
That's itches, switches.
Did you hear all of that, Kathy? I'll be glad to read it again if somebody will make a request.
Read it again,
there.
Read it again.
We don't care.
Would you like another reading there?
Calls?
Yes.
Very milky.
There was a young heiress named Fitches who had simply incredible twitches.
Twitches.
She asked Dr. Blade to come to her aid, so he quickly removed her blanks.
I love it.
Right.
You
said. Isn't this great? You having a good time, Richard? You're staying up late and everything?
And you can write that yourself.
Okay. Ready, Charles?
There was a young man.
Yes. Kathy?
I think it's
Do you want to hear it again, or is...
I'm ready.
You're ready?
Yeah.
All right, so she asked Dr. Blade to come to her aid, so he quickly removed her...
Itches.
Her itches.
What?
Itches.
You're a bad bunch. I know what you're thinking of.
Are you sure you're ready?
We don't play those games around here.
Maybe not.
Okay. Richard, she said itches.
The hell, we don't play those games. I said britches.
Brett?
I know you used to be a dancer, but you've got to stop walking like your name is Nancy.
No, I just walk in the fifth position all the time.
Constantly.
Yes.
Looks like a duck.
So he quickly removed
her old britches.
Her old britches. Okay. Charles?
Itches is a good answer, but she didn't get them till the britches were about.
Okay. Itches is not scoring for you, Kathy. What scores for you here?
Certainly not in britches.
No.
I found it very rude and tasteless. I said stitches.
Stitches. That's another good one. Yeah. All right. Yes, sir. What do you say, Richard?
I say, why don't we get out of here? Go dancing. Well, I asked the doctor to remove her... her, B-R-I-T-C-A...
Britches.
Her britches.
Oh,
okay,
britches.
She's looking for itches.
Britches.
Oh, I had an itch once.
So tell us about your answer. I don't care about your personal
problems. My doctor removed my britches to get to my itches.
Britches, okay. So at the end of round one, we got no score here at all. Let's go to round two and ask Dick Harper to make a selection.
I'll try A again.
A, here we go. Everybody plays. They threw Melvin out of the zoo when they caught him blanking a giraffe. Melvin was in the zoo, and they threw him out when they caught him blanking a giraffe. Write something quickly, because we're getting near the end of the line here.
Okay.
Ready, Charles?
Ready.
All right. Everybody ready? Okay, Dick. They threw Melvin out of the zoo when they caught him blanking a... Wait a minute. Brett, what are you
Wait
doing?
Wait a minute. Okay. Go ahead.
They threw Melvin out of the zoo when they caught him blanking a giraffe.
Kissing.
Kissing a giraffe.
Yes.
kissing a giraffe, he said. Richard, what do you say?
Well, because of the conformation of the animal, I just put it differently. Necking.
Necking with. Does that match kissing? It does match kissing. Brett. Oh,
you better be nice to me the next time I call you and tell there's a burglar in my house. Necking.
Necking, kissing, another match there. Charles.
I said climbing. I'm sorry.
Climbing a giraffe. That's an interesting answer because I got a long neck and all that thing. It's okay.
It's all
right. Let me see yours, please.
No.
Yes.
It distinctly says, don't feed the animals. So I said feeding.
Feeding. Oh, I see.
But I thought of kissing.
All right. Yes, sir, Richard.
I always believe in supporting my local police. Necking.
Necking. Okay.
I hope you remember that, officer.
That's three for you, okay?
I know I'm never going to get a ticket because I'm
necking.
I know you are.
Okay. We got to stop right here for a second or two and find out what's going on with you out there. Here it is. Just a few seconds to say that Kay Stevens is at the Eden Rock Hotel, sitting at the bar. And we hope you'll be able to join us here next time when we all get together for fun and games of Match Game 74. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.